Good morning, guys. It is Sunday and I woke up this morning and, like, not to be dramatic, but I had to, like, double check myself and be like, wait, I'm still in North Carolina, right? So the storm, like, started coming through last night and I was like, oh, it's just gonna be like freezing rain. We're not gonna actually get any snow. And, you know, obviously I've seen storms worse than this, but I woke up and I was like, what the hell? Am I actually in North Carolina? Because there's like, and now it's freezing rain, but there's like a significant amount of snow out there. And I was going to go to the gym, but then I was like, well, realistically, like, there's a pretty good chance it won't be open because this weather doesn't really faze me. Like, you know, I've seen worse. I'm from New England, but I feel like the locals aren't used to this kind of weather because they've been making a really big deal out of it on the news. The roads have not been cleaned, like, haven't been touched. So I'm just gonna work out at my, like, complex gym, which is kind of like a hotel gym, but better because they do have a squat rack, a ton of kettlebells. They do have some machines. So I'm gonna hit shoulders this morning. So I'm gonna take you guys along with me because, like, I rarely ever see, when I go by, I rarely ever see anybody in there. So, like, the odds of me making a fool out of myself recording is, like, pretty slim to none. So why don't we go hit shoulders and we'll come home and make a bomb ass, comfy, cozy, winter weather kind of feels. Sorry, Sadie just hit the tripod. Anyway, we'll come home and make a bomb-ass breakfast after.
Be mine.
I just put breakfast together. It's like 10:30 now. I was feeling like I wanted something like cozy, and whenever it's cold out, I always really crave oatmeal. And I realized I hadn't had hot oatmeal in a while. I've been eating overnight oats for work, cold, which have been good, but today just seemed like a cozy kind of a day. So I made 35 grams of oats, put a banana on there, chocolate hummus, and I mixed in some protein for oats from PE Science. Some of this in there. And then I've got an egg, egg whites, spinach, laughing cow wedge, and salsa, kind of my usual. And then a cup of coffee, and I threw some light whipped cream on there. So I'm gonna eat that. I don't really have much going on today. I have to meal prep for work tomorrow, probably clean, like, you know, kind of Sunday scaries type of stuff. But people have been asking me like what my competition plans are for next year, so maybe I'll talk to you guys about that later, just because it is something that I've been thinking about, so might as well share where I currently am at with that. So I'm starving. I'm gonna eat this and then I will check in with you guys later. Okay, so like I had alluded to before, I had mentioned that I would potentially talk about what my future competition or competing goals are, and the only reason this comes up is because it's almost like people know when there's something new are thinking about, because like honestly, so many people in the last few weeks, like people that I don't even know, like people at the gym have asked me, and people on social media have asked me like, oh, like are you in prep right now? When is your next show? When are you gonna step on stage again? Like, you know, whatever, you know, stuff like that. And it's just like, it's funny because it's almost like subconsciously people know that it's something you've been thinking about, if that makes any sense. Or maybe I just notice it more now because I've been thinking about it. Like, you know, maybe this is stuff people always ask me and I never really think about it because I've always known like what I want my next step to be. And ever since I came out of my last prep, I have had this gut feeling, like my gut has been telling me for the last 6 months, like Elzbieta, do not prep next year, like take time off. And it's funny because looking back on this past show season, there's a part of me that is kind of like, well, maybe I should have actually taken this year off. Like there's just a part of me that feels like I prepped hard, calories were low, cardio was high. I had to push like really hard, and I'm happy with the package I brought, but I didn't feel like it was my best. Like I think my body was trying to tell me like, hey, we shouldn't do this, but I was so stubborn. And when I came out of my first season, my only goal was to start. I was like, when can I start prep again? And now I'm kind of like taking a step back from that, and like, yes, I love competing, and yes, I have every intention of competing again, but I recognize that stepping back and taking a year off, like, wouldn't be a bad idea, you know? Prep is hard. It's hard on your body. It's hard on you mentally. Even if you do prep responsibly and you give yourself a lot of time and, you know, you're safe about it, and then you reverse diet appropriately and you eat enough, you know, for X amount of months, it's a lot of stress on your body. Like, dieting down is not easy. It's not natural. It's not normal. And so there's a part of me that realizes that my body would definitely appreciate a break from dieting. Like, I competed 2 years in a row. After my first season, I reversed for 4 months, and then really I only ate at the calories that I got to for 2.5 months before I started prep again. Like, looking back, I recognize that is not enough time to be eating at maintenance or a little bit higher than maintenance before you start cutting again. Like, that's not enough of a break for your metabolism. That's not enough time for your body to kind of rebalance and recenter and refocus and, you know, be like at homeostasis again. Like, I recognize that. And I think I just had this mentality of like, oh, I'm a competitor now. I have to prep every year because, you know, so-and-so does that, or, you know, so-and-so will be in a 3 month off season and then they're prepping again. And it's like, it's so easy to get caught up in what other people are doing, and especially people that, you know, you admire in the sport. It's really easy to get caught up in what other people are doing and feel like, oh, well, if they're doing it, I need to do it. And that's not necessarily the case. I have noticed that there's an increasing popularity in taking time off and, you know, taking a year off. And I'm not saying that that is like why I think I should do it because other people are doing it, but I just, seeing other people do it has made me recognize the benefits of it. And, you know, people always say, like, you want to be in, this is a sport, bodybuilding is a sport that you want to be in for the long term. And to do that, you have to be okay with taking a longer off season, putting in the work. You know, like my coach always says, the stage will always be there. And that's true. The stage isn't going anywhere. You know, whether you take 6 months off or 6 years off, like, the stage will always be there. And so I've just had this, like, internal, I don't want to say battle, but this, like, kind of internal back and forth with myself being like, well, you know, I definitely don't want to start prep right after the new year because, like, yes, I reversed well, but then I had all the stress of finding a job in a new state, finding a place to live, relocating, starting a new job. Like, my diet was not on point in the sense of I wasn't eating enough, and that's not gonna help me. And I'm not somebody who puts muscle on easily, and I'm also a natural athlete, which also means I don't put on muscle easily. I am natural. It's easy for me to be lean. Like, I naturally walk around at a leaner body mass, but I don't put muscle on easily. And, you know, that's half the battle, at least, is being able to put on the muscle and then keep it on when you cut. So there's just a part of me that recognizes that, you know, taking a year off, like, wouldn't be the worst thing. Give my metabolism a break from dieting, give myself the mental break, just the freedom to, you know, keeping goals in mind and having some sort of structure and regimen, yes, but being able to step out of that, you know, once in a while, and that be okay. Like, yes, I love bodybuilding. Like, yes, I love the theory of the sport, and I love, like, the hustle and the grind of prep and the sport, but I also recognize that, you know, it's a sport. Like, it's a hobby, you know, there's more to life than bodybuilding. And so just the last 2 years, like, I've really enjoyed them, and I've learned a lot about myself, and I've met a lot of great people, but it's hard. Like, you know, anyone who has competed before will tell you being in prep is hard, reverse dieting is hard, and the hard work doesn't scare me. It doesn't bother me at all. I have no problem doing the hard work. I have no problem being hungry. I have no problem getting up at 4:30 to do cardio, go work a 12-hour shift, and then go back to the gym to lift and do cardio. Like, I don't
it doesn't bother me to have to weigh out every gram and every ounce of food, to always have a plan, to eat out of Tupperware. Like, none of that bothers me. Like, that is not something I shy away from. Like, bring it. I, like, you know, like, I maybe I'm a little bit of a masochist. Maybe it's because I'm so type A, but like, that shit does not bother me. But now I feel like I'm rambling. But basically, I've just recognized, and like I said, I've had this gut feeling that taking a longer off season would benefit me, because just it gives me more time to be eating at maintenance or a little bit of a surplus. It gives me more time and energy to work hard in the gym, to make more gains ideally, to better my physique, to give myself a mental break from the dieting. And I just, because the next time I step on stage, regardless of when that is, I truly, genuinely, 100% want to bring the best physique I have ever brought. Like, I want to step on stage and have people be like, yep, this girl's got it. Like, she's gonna kill it. And that is my goal. And I recognize that to get that to that goal takes some patience, consistency, hard work, but you also have to be smart about it. So anyway, as of right now, I have no plans of stepping on stage in 2019. Now, I know that's easier said than done, because I am one of those people where I will see other people starting to prep and it'll give me that itch. It'll make me want to prep, and y'all have to keep me accountable. I have to keep myself accountable. I recognize that is not necessarily my best interest, not necessarily my smartest idea or smartest plan, and instead I need to be patient. I need to keep my head down, keep my eyes on my own paper, do the freaking work, and then the next time I come back and I step on stage, I am going to be the best. At least my best, because at the end of the day, your only competition is yourself. If you are in the sport to win and to be the best, your mind isn't necessarily in the right spot, because if you don't come out being the best every time, you're not gonna have that motivation. You're not gonna have that drive to stay in the sport. Your only competition is yourself, and I recognize that. My only goal is to be better than I was the last time I stepped on stage, to be stronger and more motivated, more driven, more disciplined, and to just do the friggin' work. So I just rambled for 10 minutes, all to say that as of right now, I don't think I'm going to step on stage in 2019. I don't plan on it. I plan on giving myself a good long off season, putting in the work, eating the food, lifting the weights, enjoying life, and ideally stepping on stage in 2020 and freaking blowing the package I brought this year just out of the water. Like, not even gonna be a comparison. So, like I said, just rambled, but that is where I'm at right now. You guys are the first to know.
All right, so I'm gonna end this here. It's Sunday night now, and I have to work tomorrow. So I gotta pack up my gym bag, plan a workout. I may work out at my apartment gym again, just because from the sounds of it, roads are not gonna be good tomorrow morning, and I trust myself and I trust my own skills, but no offense to you Southerners, don't trust you guys as much in snow and ice. So I might just play it safe for one more day, and that way I don't risk being safe or late for work. But anyway, as always, I appreciate you guys so much. Thank you for watching. If you like this kind of stuff, give it a thumbs up. If not, give it a thumbs down. Either way, the feedback is appreciated. I will put my Instagram handle and my email down in the description box if you want to contact me for anything, or follow me. And all my discount codes are down in the box as well. If you want to treat yourself, treat somebody else to a little something something, why not save yourself a little money while you're doing it? If you're feeling a little sassy and a little saucy, go ahead and hit the subscribe button. That would be much appreciated, especially if you're someone who is coming back and watching my videos. Like, don't be afraid to commit. It's okay. Go ahead and hit the subscribe button. And if you're feeling extra saucy, go and hit the notification button. If you've been around lately, you've probably noticed that I am very irregular with when I post, and I apologize for that. I try and put myself on more of a schedule, but life gets busy, life gets crazy. You know, this isn't like, I'm not making a living from this, so it's like something I enjoy doing, but I can't always commit to it, you know, every week, whatever. Also, my life is kind of boring, so anyway, so super consistently inconsistent. So if you want to keep like up to date with me, I would recommend doing that. And as always, again, thank you, love you guys, and I will see you in the next one.